Good day, students. We're going to look at the heat module today. So I will do the first part of the heat module. The heat module is made up of these topics: the heat and temperature, measuring instruments of temperature, propagation of heat, which is heat transfer, physical effects of heat, heat capacity and specific heat capacity, as well as linear expansion. This is a very important module. It's covered up to your N3 science, so you better make sure that you understand it. So today we're going to look at heat and temperature, the measuring instruments, the heat transfer, as well as the effects of heat. Okay, hope it's not going to be too long. Okay. So you need to know the difference between heat and temperature. What is heat? Heat is a form of energy, as we've already discussed when we looked at form of energies. And heat is measured in joules, because all energy is measured in joules. So the joules will tell you how much heat a substance has. However, temperature is not heat. Temperature only indicates the degree of heat. Basically, it tells you how intense is the heat contained in a body. So it's scientifically proven that all matter contains an amount of heat in it. You will learn about it when we get to N2, when we learn about enthalpy and entropy. So all matter contains an amount of heat in it. You can consider the example that if you put ice cubes into water, they melt. Why do they melt? They receive the heat from the tap water. As much as we naturally, we don't think tap water contains any heat, but the ice cubes receive heat from the tap water, and that is why they melt. So temperature does not tell you how much heat a body has, because all substances already have heat. But what it does, it tells you how intense is the heat within a body. Hence, it can be measured even up to below zero. It basically tells you how intense is the heat. So temperature indicates the degree of heat. It indicates the heat intensity of the body. It's the hotness or coldness of the body. So it doesn't tell you how much heat a body has. The joules will tell you how much heat a body has. And temperature is measured in degrees Celsius or in Kelvins. Now the Kelvins is used for higher temperatures. We refer to it as a thermodynamic scale. For temperatures that they use in industry, in furnaces, they mostly will measure in Kelvins. But for domestic temperatures, we will use degrees Celsius. You need to be able to convert from degrees Celsius or Kelvins and vice versa. This you need to note: 0 degrees Celsius is equivalent to 273 Kelvins. So if you have degrees Celsius and you want to convert to Kelvins, you simply add 273, whatever value you have. And if you want to convert from Kelvins to degrees Celsius, from what you have, you subtract the 273. Then we need to look at instruments that are used to measure temperature. As you might already identify, these are thermometers. So there are three instruments that we're going to look at: the mercury thermometer, the alcohol thermometer, as well as the optical pyrometer. Okay. Now the first two is basically the same thing. It's what we call a clinical thermometer. And then a mercury thermometer will have mercury inside, then an alcohol thermometer will have alcohol inside, but they are both the same. So the first thing that what you need to know with these thermometers, you need to be able to give the advantages and the disadvantages, and you need to be able to put it in a sketch as well. So let's look at the sketch first. So that is how you sketch a thermometer, whether it's a mercury thermometer or an alcohol thermometer. So you must show, okay, let me do it so that you can see. You must show the outside housing, so you can label that. You can say it's the glass tube, you can say it's the glass tube, or you can say it's the housing, because this is basically the housing of the thermometer. And then this part here is called the bulb. It's called the bulb. And inside will be the liquid.
one they asked you to sketch. So you put that specific liquid that they asked for you to sketch. And then there is that narrow tube. This here is normally reddish in color. This is a narrow tube. So this narrow tube is the one that when you measure the temperature, this is the part, for instance, sometimes they measure under your arm or under your tongue. So if they put it under your arm, this part is going to sense the heat of your body. So what the liquid will do, whether it's mercury or alcohol, it's going to expand. So as it expands, it's going to give the temperature reading. So this here, you will say, this is your temperature scale. So as it expands, based on the heat that it's sensing over there, it's going to give the temperature reading. So that is how you sketch. So these, all these labels must show the scale, the narrow tube, the liquid, the bulb, and the glass tube. So it's normally 2 or 3 marks depending on the generosity of the examiner. But in most cases, each label is 0.5 mark, and the correctness of the sketch will also be 0.5 mark. So you must always put labels when you do a sketch. Okay, so let's look at the advantages and the disadvantages. Let's start with the mercury thermometer. The mercury thermometer does not stick to the glass. So as it expands, it gives a clear expansion. Even when it shrinks back, it leaves the glass clear. So that's what they mean is when they say it does not stick to the glass tube. And then it has a uniform expansion. It expands uniformly on all sides of the tube. And also it's a good conductor of heat, so it's going to sense even the slightest change in terms of heat. And then it is clearly visible. It also has a high boiling point of 375 degrees Celsius, so it can measure temperatures that high. And these are the advantages of the mercury thermometer. And what are the disadvantages of the mercury thermometer? The expansion of mercury is very small. Even though it senses heat, but it tends to expand very, very slowly, and its expansion is small. And also, it can evaporate. So when it gets to that 375 degrees Celsius, it's likely to evaporate. And then, it is more expensive than alcohol. It's more expensive, so that is a disadvantage. So disadvantage is what is bad about it. And it is also poisonous. So should it break, it's poisonous. And also, it does not work below minus 39 degrees. So it freezes at minus 39 degrees Celsius. Those are the disadvantages of the mercury. So you must know the advantages as well as the disadvantages of using mercury as your liquid. Then let's look at the alcohol thermometer. The alcohol thermometer will start off with advantages. It has a very low freezing point of minus 130. Some texts would say minus 80 degrees. So any of the two is correct. It has a very low freezing point. So that means when you get to the point where the mercury freezes, the alcohol will continue up to minus 130 degrees. So that's a very good point about it, that it can measure temperatures that low. And then it can be, you can dye it, you can add color, usually red, to make it more visible. So to measure temperatures, for instance, at the bottom of a swimming pool where it's far, you can use alcohol thermometer, you can add the color so that you can see from far. Whereas mercury is clear. And then it is cheaper than mercury, that's an advantage, and it has a large expansion with the increase in temperature, so that readings are more accurate. What are the disadvantages of the alcohol, of using alcohol in your thermometer? The top of the column of the liquid is hollow and not so easily read. So when it expands, if this is your tube, it makes something like this. It doesn't have a uniform expansion. So that's a disadvantage of the alcohol. And then it clings to the glass tube. Even when it has to shrink back,
is gonna leave some marks on the glass tube. Therefore, it makes it difficult to read. And also, it has a low boiling point of 78 degrees. So that means you can only measure temperatures up to 78 degrees, whereas with mercury, you can go higher, up to 378. So that's a disadvantage for the alcohol. It has a low boiling point. And then, it is a poor conductor of heat. The optical parameter, we will look at it in class because it's a lesson on its own. Okay, so thank you.